Remembrance Sunday and Armistice Day are times when, for a short time, friends and strangers alike pause in silence. Schools and businesses take a moment of quiet. People might even pop into churches or stop in the streets, as this nation and some other nations take a deep breath and really focuses on the costs of war and conflict. There will always be somebody who resorts to conflict to assert a view on how the world or their part of it should be, or at least that's what they think. So this year, amongst all the difficulties of COVID, we do the same. Any gatherings will be small, they'll be distanced, but they will be very important. The poppy has become a powerful image, particularly in the battlefields or growing on present-day farmland, laid as wreaths in ceremonies at home and around the world, or perhaps worn by you. Perhaps poppies have been more difficult to get this year. Usually many people would be out taking part in the traditional poppy selling appeal, and collection points would be everywhere. But in whatever ways we get our poppies this year, they symbolise that service and suffering in the struggle for what is right and for peace is never forgotten, and that the beauty and love of God can and will shine through again and again.
The school remembers with sadness and pride the part played by its old boys in times of armed conflict. It also remembers the 12 men of Tongsville who died in the First World War. The names of the old boys are commemorated in the school chapel, and the names of the men of Tongs on the memorial stone. A total of 130 old boys saw active service in the First World War, of which 30 were killed, a proportion of just under 1 in 4. 25 were awarded military distinctions, a list which includes 7 DSOs and 10 MCs. A total of 238 old boys fought in the Second World War. 40 were killed. A total of 81 distinctions were won, of which there were 15 DSOs, 13 MCs, and 7 DFCs. I now read the Roll of Honour. The Men of Tongs. Private Spencer Collins. Private George Hickmott. Lieutenant Charles Gunther. Lieutenant Norman Gunther. Private Frederick Hansen. Private Alexander Meany. Private Percy Moore. Private Charles Potter. Private Frank Rich. Private Percy Stanbridge, Private Henry Weller, and Corporal Herbert Wickham. World War I. Lieutenant Edward Bostock, Lieutenant Neville Bostock, Captain George Cartland, Lieutenant George Colden, Lieutenant Philip Cornish, Lieutenant Walter Crick, Lieutenant John Delap, Lieutenant Robert Frank, Lieutenant George Jameson, Lieutenant George Goodall, Captain Isaac Hadley, Captain Claude Haygate, Lieutenant Colonel Philip Holberton, Lieutenant Lionel Hughes, Lieutenant Robert DeLeith, Major John Maidlow, Lieutenant Roderick Matheson, Lieutenant Ian Matheson, Lieutenant Alexander Matheson, Captain Richard Morgan, Lieutenant William Nelson, Lieutenant Holford Plant, Lieutenant Cecil Raymond Parker, Lieutenant Douglas Richardson, Lieutenant John Tanner, Lieutenant Richard Tillier, Captain Roland Vasey, Lieutenant Andrew Walker, Lieutenant Duncan Wallace, Captain Cecil Winter, and the Second World War. Flight Lieutenant Simon Ackland, Major Richard Arbuthnot, Captain Gilbert Beale, Captain Michael Bidoff, Lieutenant Stephen Bingay, Lieutenant Michael Bosworth Smith, Captain Peter Bray, Captain Sir James Croft, Captain Cecil Cutlack, Lieutenant Colonel George Dyson, Lieutenant John Eustace, Captain Colin Ferguson, Squadron Leader John Govan, Major Gilchrist Gregson, Commander Robert Griffith, Squadron Leader Philip Hanbury, Lieutenant John Harper, Major Edward Harvey, Lieutenant Commander Patrick Havers, Lieutenant Eric Horn, Captain John Hoyle, Captain Nicholas Humphreys, Midshipman the Honourable John Jocelyn, Flight Lieutenant George Langdon, Lieutenant John Loveday, Flight Officer Colin McPherson, Lieutenant Robert Money, Wing Commander Reginald Morgan Smith, Lieutenant Desmond Penrose, Lieutenant Commander Rodney Price, Sub-Lieutenant Dennis Robertson, Lieutenant Edward Skinner, Lieutenant John Skinner, Major Robert Thomas, Lieutenant David Thompson, Lieutenant Anthony Trollope Bellew, Sergeant John Vasey, Captain John Venables, Brigadier Frank Vogel, and Lance Corporal Charles Young.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
When you go home, tell them of us and say, "For your tomorrow, we gave our today."
Let us pray. God, it is difficult to see the point of wearing a poppy sometimes, or what difference 2 minutes silence will make when we could be shouting protests. But we can recognise a broken life being valued, a gift being given, and taking a minute to reflect on how much we have. We look to the future, not to the past. We cannot change what has been, but do not need to repeat its mistakes. So as young and old come together before you, take the very best of our lives, bind us into one people of faith, and help us to share our common values, love of Jesus and care for each other, to build dreams and with your Holy Spirit, turn them into reality. Amen.